The planetary cleanup has begun, and it has nothing to do with who is president. What does the result of election 2020 determine for you? That your life is secure? That your rights will be upheld? That your health is honored? That the pandemic will just go away? That racial inequality, organized pandemics, hate, unhealthy school systems, children in cages, the poisoning of our planet will just magically go away? This system is built on all of that. Not by one specific party, our current system was built by all parties. It is a detrimental foundation for the overall well-being of our citizens. It was created by a lower collective consciousness that allowed it to happen. We can change all of that, but only as a unified collective. We cannot, however, do it from the same level of mind that created this shit show. We have to raise our perspective to a higher level of emotional intelligence to truly change it. What I saw in the debates and in campaign ads is what I see on social media: low emotional intelligence. These two candidates are a reflection of the childish behavior of our collective. Harsh words, yes, but that is the harsh reality right now. What are you doing to change any of that? What is the part you take responsibility to change? This is what I really want to know. I don't care who you voted for, quite frankly. I want to know that you are passionate about something, about creating change, so much that you're actually doing something about it. What we choose to do now, individually, will determine how this next presidency unfolds. We are the collective consciousness that decides what our future will look like. Do you get that? Continue settling for voting for the lesser of two evils is an ignorant choice that has been far overused in our modern times. I want candidates that make it hard to choose from because they both have ideas that innovate and transform our broken systems. They have different pathways to achieve it, and they can achieve it because they are not influenced by the big money lobbyists who have their agendas to uphold, not yours. These candidates stand firm in who they are. They are not easily swayed or lured. They have lived a life that is based on morality of self, so there are no skeletons that can be used against them for governmental favors of any kind. Think this sounds like a far-fetched idea for how our worldwide government systems evolve? I don't. And if you hang in with me long enough on this video, I'll reveal how this is happening right now, while our world still loudly debates what will happen in a Biden presidency now that Trump is out. Do not allow that noise to overpower the inner wisdom of who you are. Stop waiting for some miracle to change the disheartening embarrassment our country has become. And that hasn't just been the last 4 years, folks. It's been in the making for a very long time. When will we collectively stop the arguing for what hasn't worked and come together for us as a collective to be the change our planet is requiring us to be? It is time for us to model an inner code of universal ethics in order to collectively activate this code of ethics into our global systems. For me personally, we as a family can no longer stand by and allow our lives to be limited by our governmental systems as we know it. We have accepted the request to be part of a team to spread this code of ethics into our human collective. Therefore, we are choosing drastic changes to do that in the highest and best for our family, and in the highest and best of our planet. We do not force these ethics on anyone. They must be chosen by each person, but live them and expect them in those we surround ourselves in. We are choosing to accept a position on this planetary team missioned with ushering in these new codes of ethics. They will challenge you, not because they limit you, but because they will set you free of all limitations if you are ready to accept the severing of these limited ties we've been living within. We are not limited beings. It's not how we are designed. Why then are we being limited? What benefit comes from limiting the collective of our rights? Could it be that bringing our unlimited collective potential to the surface terrifies the shit out of the leaders of our country, our corporations, our religions, and our systems. Why would they be terrified of losing power? Maybe it's because their unlimited power is manufactured. If power is manufactured, it isn't power. It's force. And if we truly know ourselves as unlimited, then limiting another is simply abuse. Our country as we know it is an abuser. The land of the free? Not anymore. Perspective changes everything. Doing the same thing over and over again, like voting in a new president groomed in our current system and hoping for a different outcome, is insanity. Period. We have been fooled by our government as well as the dark forces that have controlled our planet for millennia. We have been fucked by a healthcare system that promotes the latest meds over whole body healthcare. Raises in taxes do not equate to raises in income. This is financial abuse. Insurance companies operate within the legal boundary of fraud. Our voices are being censored because they do not speak of the overall narrative being given to us. Does this concern you as much as it does me? If it does, then you are ready to hear the evolution of our global systems. This is an upgraded code of ethics that our planet will be moving towards from here on out. These codes are not written by any individual human or collective of humans, which removes any chance of subjective agendas of the collective. These codes have been provided by ascended souls that understand the overall codes of universal balance and are working with sentient beings here on Earth to instill these codes into the collective. I have been asked to share a portion of these codes today for those who are ready to shift into a higher realm of being in their own physical bodies and integrate these higher states into our planetary evolution. If these codes resonate with you, you are being asked to ascend into higher versions of yourself in an SOS type call to help with the higher mission to spread these codes throughout the collective. In other words, you are being asked to be part of the universal team of light to incorporate the entire code of ethics into our planet. It's like nothing we have experienced in this lifetime. Therefore, it will stretch your belief systems, yet touch that deep wisdom of truth within. These codes are our inherent nature, and this is what is being introduced into our planet as we speak. It's a systemized code of inner ethics that will govern our planetary systems moving forward. Right now, we are in the clearing space. This means clearing the residue of dis-ease that the dark forces created by running our systems in inappropriate and life-constricting ways. I'm going to share one of these four codes with you. Each has several subsets. You will operate under these codes as quickly as a strategic collective chooses to drop the belief in the fear-based systems that have suffocated our human spirit for thousands of years and embrace the new codex of our individual rights. If you are ready to embrace these new codes with full belief and without any fear of cutting ties to the unlawful codes you've been living within, then you will be guided and trained in this recoding process. But you have to choose it now in order to live it. Here's a portion of the codes of the new earth. Section 1, the law of divine grace. Each sentient being has an unalienable and unconditional right to positive life experience. To explain Section 1, we need to understand that suffering and pain have no value in enlightened universal society liberated from the influence of dark forces and other aspects of cosmic anomaly. To value pain, suffering, and sacrifice as a part of the growth experience was a part of the programming from the dark forces thousands of years ago in order to enslave the population of our planet more easily. Unconditional positive life experience of every sentient being in the liberated earth is guaranteed from the interconnection of every living being with the source, and strengthened by the power of ascended masters over matter, which allows them to assist all living beings in their aspirations towards the source and provide them with necessities of life. Life was never meant to be hard work and struggle, but rather a journey of joy and creativity. Different subsections of Section 1 regulate all life in a liberated planet and all relationships being evolved human beings so that conflicts never need to occur. There are 5 subsections to the Law of Divine Grace, which I will share tomorrow on the 1111 portal activation being held in the Ascension Network. I'll also be sharing the 4 laws and the 4 other laws and their subsections as well. What I will say right now is this. These laws have been strategically hidden from us for millennia. However, now is the time in history when they resurface and you will feel their inherent truth deep within you. You will know they are the way we are meant to live. And I'll remind you, these codes are currently being offered to humans now. When offered, you choose the set of laws in which you have wanted to live. Choose the ones you've consciously know and you will remain in the world as you know it. Choose the ones we'll cover on the 1111 portal activation, and we will also activate these laws into your field, and you will watch as your life organizes itself to adopt these new laws. And yet they're not new. They are very ancient and they are very familiar to who you inherently are. This will be a powerful event that symbolizes the beginning of this movement to the ascension of Earth and its inhabitants. Together, we will walk through the 1111 portal as a team of beings fully committed to the humanitarian ascension of our planet. With the powerful energies of the 1111 portal, I'll reveal the rest of the codes. We'll discuss further details of your part of this covert movement, answer any questions, and gain accurate awareness of your part in this massive evolutionary process of humanity. Join the Ascension Network today with the 7-day trial to secure your spot in the 1111 portal activation. It's completely free. You can cancel easily at any time or stay for a while as we continue our training on being a vital part in this earthly transition. Continuing in the Ascension Network is only $10.99 a month. Allow yourself the gift of unlimited potential and break free of the shackles of limitations you've been unlawfully held in. This is a collective breaking free of these shackles. I know this because I'm one of them. My request is that you join me on this important mission. There will be no recording emailed out of this activation. This is a sacred message. The recording will be archived in the Ascension Network, therefore you must show up live or access the recording in the Ascension Network platform to hear the sacred and transformational message. You can get access to the Ascension Network and more at vedettemeyer.com/network. Thank you for being here. Thank you for listening to this message. And once again, I invite you to be part of this team that is taking us into a whole new evolution of life here on Earth and life here in our spiritual selves. Thank you for being here. I love you. I appreciate you. We'll see you soon. Mwah. Thank you for listening to the Ascension Network podcast. This is where you'll find daily energetic upgrades to guide you through the intense transformational times we are navigating. Each daily message dives deeply into the frequencies of human life and gives new perspectives on how to shift them into higher states of being and higher states of global impact. Get full access to daily upgrades, plus monthly pyramid activations, weekly abundance code upgrades, weekly energy readings, the community, and events all within the Ascension Network. Join us at vedettemeyer.com. I'm your host, Vedette Meyer, and as a collective, we are ascending into higher frequencies of being to hold space for all of humanity to ascend into the new Earth.